Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to take a simple exercise in SOLIDWORKS sheet metal, and we will learn some basic sheet metal features like boss base flange, edge flange. We will see how to use fold and unfold features to create this kind of oblong holes. Let's make a simple exercise in SOLIDWORKS with the help of sheet metal tool or sheet metal feature. So here we will learn some basic features. So this is our main exercise. See this one. We will take this outer line. See this inside radius 20. The inside distance from here to here 100 millimeter. Now this angle is 90 degree. It is missing actually here. But this angle is 90 degree. Then you will see the distance from outer line is 12, means inner line is 10 millimeter, inside radius 2 millimeter. And how long we need to extrude? You will see here 15, 40, 15, it's 70 millimeter. Now let's first right click on any tabs, go to tabs and activate sheet metal. See, if you click directly on sheet metal base flange, it will ask you plane. So I'll choose front plane. Now this is our sketch. So let me start with sketch. Now let's start with a kind of geometry. Now here I'll choose this two tangent. Okay, these two lines tangent. This is important relation. And these two lines also make sure tangent to each other. Now if I am going to move, see, it's going to move. Now let me choose one more relation. Hold shift key and choose these two equal. That's it. I'll make one center line. Draw one vertical construction line. Select these three lines. Symmetric relation. Okay. One more relation, these two horizontal in same line, that's it. Now, this 90 degree already defined. This one we calculated, it's 10 millimeter. Now, the outer distance 100 millimeter. Well, now we forget to add one important thing, 3-point arc geometry. Okay, now select this point, hold shift key and origin point, merge. Smart dimension 20 millimeter, this is the radius. Now we need to trim, go to trim entity, power trim, just trim these two lines. Now see, drawing is underdefined, so I'll add some geometry like this. Okay, see, this is fully defined. Now exit base flange and I'll choose this line. Now see, it's moving downward side. See, that's why we took this dimension 10 millimeter. After all, it becomes 12 millimeter. Now direction 1, length 70, but keep end condition mid plane. You will see isometric view. See, it's moving both side. Now comes to gauge, thickness 2 millimeter we will keep, radius 2 millimeter. I'll say yes. Let's deactivate real view so that we will get. Now if I am going to go evaluate, measure, and I'll choose inside radius, see, 2 millimeter. Clear. If you check this inside 2 millimeter, outside radius always inside radius plus thickness. So it's become 4 millimeter. You will see here. Okay. This flange is 22 millimeter away from here and 14 millimeter from outer edge. See, and this radius R 10. There is a hole also, 4 number of holes, and this hole diameter 5. And if you check here, see thickness 2 millimeter and the bend is outside. Even one more important thing we need to check here. See, there is a one corner relief, and this relief thickness depth 2 millimeter and 1 millimeter from here. So this is important relation. Then we will make one hole and we will mirror this hole 15 millimeter away from this end and 14 millimeter from this end and 5 millimeter. Now I'll choose edge flange and I'll choose, let's say, this edge, go upside, and now this is, now first make distance from virtual sharp edge, means the virtual point of this both end, and this material outside. If I'm going to show you, see exactly the thickness is just outside, comes here, edit flange. This is the important part we are going to make. 3-point arc, connect these 2 points and make this okay. Distance, now distance from bottom edge, it's 14. Now distance from here to center point, 20. 10 millimeter is the radius. Now center line construction, see, this is, it seems fully defined sketch. Just click back and you will see. Now we've outside, okay. Now the next important thing is corner relief, custom relief type. Now here choose rectangle, uncheck relief ratio, and here the width 2 millimeter. See, the width is increased 2 millimeter, and the depth, it's 1 millimeter. This is the 1 millimeter depth in both sides. Say yes. Look, because depth always equal to or more than thickness. Oh, sorry, width. Now I'll choose hole. I'll select this face. Here make diameter 5. And just move this cursor and you'll find, keep your cursor near edge and you'll find center point. See, it is fully defined. Link to thickness. Yes, the hole is created. Now one more hole we need to create here. Hole, link to thickness 5 millimeter. Okay, even though let's edit a sketch and define the sketch for this hole. Now distance from outer 14 millimeter, 15 millimeter. Exit. Now the hole and everything defined. Even though let's define a blue color to this geometry. Okay. Now let's mirror this. Go to mirror. I choose plane. Front plane is the perfect for this. That's why we choose mid plane for base flange. Now feature to mirror, I'll choose 1, 2 and second hole. These 3 features, even though you can choose or select from here, say yes. Mirror. Now this time I'll choose right plane and I'll choose mirror. Say okay. Now see, if I am going to sheet metal and choose flatten, and you will get a perfect shape. Look, this is the ready for machining purpose. Now let's say some more hole here going to add. Now we need to add this a kind of oblong, this size 15 by 12 millimeter, and center distance is 40 millimeter, radius 7.5. So we will first unfold, then we will add. We can't directly do this, otherwise the things will change. This is the bending table, we don't need this bending table. Okay, the rest is, let's check unfold. I'll choose, this is fixed plane, collect all bend, yes, it is open. Now I'll choose this face, sketch. Now let's define one center vertical and horizontal line, rectangle. Tap 15. I'll define this. This radius, it's 7.5, enter. The same, this area 7.5, enter. Okay. One important distance from here to here, it's 15. Okay, now select inside these two lines and make construction geometry. Now mirror entity, I'll choose this all lines, mirror about this vertical line. You will see the preview here, say yes. Now in sheet metal you will find option or features extruded cut. Either you can define dimension, keep if you unchecked, and you can simply define dimension. Otherwise you simply click link to thickness, it will cut only up to thickness. Yes, look. Now let's try to fold. Click fold. Now fixed face already selected, because we already choose this face as unfold. Collect all bend, say yes. Now look. So this is the simple tutorial. If you check unfold, flat pattern, right click, export to DXF, save any forms. Now faces loop, let's say sheet metal, and if you want to add some like bend line, okay, there is no forming tool and anything, sketch line also no need, and we don't need to allocate any dimensions or anything, say yes. If you say yes, it's going to calculate and see, this is our main 2D drawing which is going to save in DXF format, and this drawing you can use in Autodesk, AutoCAD or any other machining purpose, say yes. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.